Man thinks he married the perfect woman. 10 years later, he discovered her darkest secret. It's terrifying to find out that the person you love hides a dark secret. You think you know that person so well and you discover that person you thought she was. And that's the case of Blake Ruff, who fell madly in love with a woman named Lori Erica Kennedy, and they were married shortly after. What started off as an honest relationship full of potential slowly spiraled into a real chaos. They met at a Texas Bible study class in 2003, and she was incredibly private about her personal life. Blake was smitten. But his family, on the other hand, was suspicious about Lori from the start because she was all by herself and never talked about her family. Despite his family's suspicions about Lori's past, Blake married his beloved in 2004 at a private ceremony, only their preacher was in attendance. Soon after, the two moved to Leonard, Texas, to start a family. Blake was thrilled to have met the love of his life. Soon after they moved, Blake and Lori wanted desperately to have a child, but it wasn't an easy path for them. Lori suffered multiple miscarriages over the course of several years. Finally, through in vitro fertilization, Lori became pregnant with a little girl, and in 2008 she gave birth to a baby. After the birth, Lori acted unusually private and distant. She was overprotective of her daughter to the point of obsession, and she wouldn't even let Blake's mother hold her. Over time, Blake's family was growing increasingly suspicious of his wife. She refused to talk about her family and became fixated on Blake's family. But soon she begged her husband's family to see the baby girl, and tension between them became seemingly unattainable, and Lori fell into depression. Even if they tried counseling in 2010 as a final attempt to save their marriage, it was too late. Lori was not the same person Blake fell in love with 7 years earlier, and the two filed for divorce the following spring. Lori's depression became dramatically worse. She lost weight, and she would ramble onto her church's pastor several times a week about her problems, fidgeting with her hands the whole time. By the end of 2010, Lori's depression and the loss of her marriage became too much for her to bear. On Christmas Eve of 2010, Lori drove to Blake's family's home in a black Tahoe and parked it outside. Then, she picked up a shotgun she'd brought with her. Lori tragically shot herself in the driver's seat of the Tahoe late Christmas Eve night. Blake's father found her body the next morning along with two suicide letters. One was for Blake, and the other was for their daughter, but the writing on both was completely unintelligible. After a lot of investigations, it turned out that Lori's real name was Kimberly McLean, and she disappeared from her family's Pennsylvania home in 1986 at age 17 just because her mother married a man she hated. Sadly, there were more secrets this woman took to the grave, but we hope that Blake and his daughter are finally happy and able to move on.